metal to the pros? Like, what's the biggest difference for you, the transition?
As far as in boxing or just as a whole?
The politics, behind the scene, in the ring, whatever. Like, what's the biggest difference?
Well, I never experienced politics in the amateurs. I don't get in that. Like, them whole politics stuff, the more you stay away from it, the more it don't come near you. I would hate to have to fight against somebody and then politics win in the fight. Now I've seen it happen, and yeah, people speak on it, but I want to keep boxing as pure as it is to me. So I just speak on who's the winner, who's the loser. I try not to think about the politics and the money, because when you start thinking about stuff like that, it kind of makes you dislike the sport. So I'm trying to continue to love boxing and not think of it that way. But the biggest thing I noticed in the amateurs and the pros, the fans. I'm mad. Listen, in the amateurs, I didn't have trolls in the amateurs. I don't know what this new wave that's going on is. But it's a bunch of trolls, a bunch of media haters. I didn't go through this stuff when I was getting ready. I dealt with nothing but professionals and amateurs and coming up for the Olympics. Then you turn pro, everybody got a camera, everybody got their own website. They can make fake news articles. Listen, look, the trolling is ridiculous for the pros. I mean, everybody got to say so. People got pages with 100,000 followers all because they hate on other people. I don't get it. And it's like, in the amateurs, people like that didn't get no attention. They got no kind of fame. Nobody cared about them. It's like, some of these guys with these boxing pages that troll people are like, kind of popular on social media. But in real life, nobody knows them. But that's what I'm saying. This whole new wave stuff in the pros is way different. I never dealt with trolls as much as I deal with them now. Like, I just be like, I'm really having to control myself because I'm trying to get sponsorships, I'm trying to get endorsements, but then you got somebody coming on your page calling you a black bee, talking about you don't know how to fight, this girl's going to beat you, you calling me bums. You got a professional media member, you know what I'm saying, coming at me, calling me stupid and ignorant, and he has a professional job. Like, it's weird. You know, and then it's so unprofessional. But in the amateurs, you would have been fired. Like, that stuff don't roll, especially when you're getting ready for the Olympics. Like, that stuff doesn't matter. But it's like in the pros, I feel like everybody has to say so. It's weird. Yeah.
What else do you think you need to do to be on Broadway? You know what I mean? Like, lights, camera, action. You've done ESPN. You did the body issue. You're a great ambassador for the sport of boxing. 2 gold medals. We can go down the list. 77-1, 8-0 in the pros.
Yeah.
What do you think for the casual fans? You got to add more sex appeal to your life. Do you have to be more? I'm just being real with you. I'm being real. Like, you know, do you got to flash money? Like, what else do you need to do? Because you've accomplished everything possible in the ring.
You know, God has told me to keep being myself. You know, I'm going to continue to grow as a person. I'm not going to do anything that I don't want to do. So if you ever see me throwing money, just know I want to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you ever see me trash talking, that's because I want to do it. But the whole sex appeal thing, look, I look good. I don't like that kind of attention, to be honest. Like, I got a really big butt. People don't know that because of how I dress. But this thing back here, like, I be trying to cover it up because I don't like that kind of attention. And I never have, you know. I just say, I just have to, you know, just keep growing as a person and keep every opportunity that I get, make the best out of it.
Who inspired you to fight?
My dad. He inspired me through a story he told me of Muhammad Ali and Layla. But it was more of, he used to love boxing. He wished somebody in our family would have took up after him. And then he said Muhammad Ali had the same problem. He had a whole bunch of sons and kids, but his daughter took up after him. So I thought my dad was telling me take up after him, but he wasn't. My dad didn't want me to box at the beginning. He told me boxing was a man's sport and said I was too pretty. Thumbs down. I'm pretty now. I wasn't pretty back then. I mean, like, my face was skinny and my nose was real big. Like my nose was like covering half my face when I was a
me
kid.
Me too, when I was a kid. That's funny.
Yeah, you see how you grow up?
Yeah, you grow up. Now I'm handsome.
Yeah. See, but that's what I'm saying. Like, so, you know, I feel like I'm going to grow into the person that I want to be. I'm not going to force myself to wear heels and show my body. Like, if I want to get dressed up and be sexy, as they call it, I will. But if I don't, I'm gonna be in my tennis shoes and my jeans. Like, I feel like God has already told me how great or how big I'm gonna be. I'm just enjoying this little downtime right now, because once it really blow up, y'all not gonna be able to talk to me in this room. Like, I'm gonna have like security guards like Floyd. Y'all gonna be like, Chris, remember? I'm like, yeah, but my security guard gonna be putting his hand in your face telling you to move, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just enjoying this downtime.
I can't wait for that day.
Right now.
I can't wait.
Because look, I'm glad this here, because when it happens, all I'm gonna do is tell everybody, I told y'all. Like, I'm the Beyonce of boxing. Like, it's for real. Beyonce don't fight, but you know what I mean.
I don't know. Maybe I.